Our next speaker is Mateus Paes Lima. He is a professor at Physics Department of UFSCar.
Hi. Mayild, in the next talk, we'll talk about perovskites. So in this presentation, we'll focus only on the two-dimensional chalcogenide materials. And the idea of this presentation is to present some ideas for using first principle simulations for obtaining some information about photovoltaic applications of chalcogenide materials. So, transition method chalcogenide material, the TMDs, is a hybrid material that can be used for several proposals. For example, there is the possibility to make a field effect transistor in the nanoelectronics, or the possibility to make use the transition method for catalysis. In that picture, it's possible to see the hydrogen breaking at the edges of the transition method chalcogenides nanoflakes. And there are other applications, such as piezoelectric materials, piezoelectric device, energy storage, sensor. However, for the Project 18, our principal interest is into photovoltaic applications. So it's important to say to you that the transition method chalcogenides have a lot of possibilities for applications. However, we in this project will focus on the photovoltaics application. Here we show a simple photovoltaic device based on ether structures of transition methods de chalcogenides. But how can DFT help to better understanding the photovoltaic materials? So my group and the group of Juarez has a large experience into performing first principle simulations based on density function theory, and standard calculations can provide several properties which are good for investigate photovoltaic devices. For example, we can calculate the band gap, and for a good photovoltaic device, we need a band gap around 1.6 electron volts for optimize the because the sun, the light of the sun. We can also calculate via density functional theory, optical properties. We can predict new materials for proposing an experiment, for example. We can investigate details, structural details, dynamics. So the density functional theory is a powerful tool to investigate possible applications for photovoltaics. Materials in photovoltaic fields. And now I will make a brief introduction about the transition method de chalcogenides. So, in generally, transition method de chalcogenides are materials with the chemical formula Mk2, where M is a metal and K is a sulfur, selenium, or tenoride. So there are many possible compositions for the TMDs. In that table, I show in red the most common metals that can be used for transition method chalcogenides. And there are other possibilities, but these are the principal atoms used for transition method chalcogenides. So there are many possible chemical compositions. And in the bottom panel here, I show the most common morphologies of the structures. So there are three most common crystal lattices, namely 2-age, 1-T, and 1-T prime. The 2-age, the top view, show bottom here, like a graphene, we have a hexagonal lattice. However, the chalcogen atoms is stacked one each other. From the 1-T structure, we have only a small modifications. The chalcogen atoms of the top are changed in respect. But for the 2-age and 1-T structures, there are exactly the same coordination number of all atoms. So are quite similar structures. And the 1-T prime is a distortion that occurs in the 1-T structure due to the Peierls distortion. So transition method chalcogenides has many possible compositions and a polymorphism. We can enlarge the number of properties in transition method chalcogenides if we further modify the structures. So here I show four possibilities to modify the structure to obtain new properties. For example, the most useful property structure for photovoltaics is the ether structure. Showing we can build vertical ether structures, stacking layers of different chalcogenide materials, or the lateral ether structures, showing in the left side the main idea. So we have a single layer, however, parts of the layers have different compositions. And for photovoltaic devices, it's very interesting to see about the band structure alignments. So that in that small figure, I show the schematic overview of the stacking of two layers, the A and B layers. So if the layer B has a large band gap and the layer A has a small band gap inside it, we have a type 1 ether structure. And we have also the type 2 and the type 3 ether structure. And the type 2 ether structure is the most important for photovoltaic applications, because with the incidence of light, there is a excitation, a creation of an electron hole pair. And if the ether structure has the type 2, the electron is in one layer, located at one layer, and the hole is located at the other layer. So it's very easy to break the electron hole pair. So in practice, most of our simulations are searching for type 2 ether structures for applications in photovoltaics devices. And the other possibilities is the generation of nanoflakes and nanoribbons. In the bottom panel, show some experimental results of 2 years ago, showing the real possibility to make nanoflakes. And these geometries are very useful too for applications in photovoltaics. And there are other emerging materials that are the monochalcogenides. I show in the upper panel here. Here I show only the two most common structures, but there are a lot of many other compositions. For example, we can build a group 4 chalcogenide materials, monochalcogenides. The world of chalcogenide materials is very big. And we have a very large possibilities for search some solution for helping photovoltaic applications. So an overview on TMDs is there are many possible chemical formulas. There are a polymorphism in this material, many possible crystal lattices. The band gap is up to 3 electron volts, which are in the visible range. So these are materials probably good for photovoltaic applications. And we still can tune the properties of materials, generate ether structures, defects, decoration, and so. However, find the better transition methods, chalcogenides or chalcogenide material for photovoltaic applications is really a very, very hard task. Nowadays, we cannot do if the better possibility is still a very hard task, and your work here is to search for possibilities for some applications. So I present some works on the past 12 months, in the past year, and some papers in the writing process. I will show only the highlights of these works. However, I present here the team. The works I will present here are from a collaboration between the UFSCar and the USP. At the USP here, the Chemical Institute of the USP, there are four students, Rafael Bessi and Augusto, are not here. However, Nigel and Julian are here, and they have a great contribution on the presented works. And at the UFSCar, I have three students that are in the beginning of the projects. So the presented results is still not have a strong contributions, but in the next presentation, the next year, I think they are. So I present some results now. This work we investigate the small nanoflakes and the intermediate size nanoflakes from several compositions. This work was published last year in the PCCP, and we investigate a lot of nanoflakes morphology and composition. And we investigate the structural properties, electronic properties, the binding energy, and our main result regards the stability of these nanoflakes. The most important, the low energy structure has triangles in the morphology. Another work is a submitted work that we interact gold nanoparticles with nanoflakes. So the principal result shown in the bottom panel is very interesting, that the OMO is at one side of the flake and LUMO is at the other side of the flake. I have not a laser here, but here. The OMO is at one side of the flake and the LUMO is at the other side. And for example, in the creation of an electron hole pair, probably we have a low binding energy between the electron hole pair. So this is another work regards the interaction between two nanoribbons of the transition method chalcogenides. And we stack the same nanoribbons, one each other, however, in different configurations. And we see that if we made small translations in the top ribbon, we have strong modifications in the electronic structure of the material and a strong variation for the magnetic moment of the material. So this work is still in progress. Another work is the investigation of the nanoflake on the top of the gold surface. This work was motivated by experimental measures. However, we simulated these systems and we found that the binding energy and the properties highly depends on the adsorption sites. We can see difference up to 2 electron volts if we make only small rotations in the nanocluster here. We also show make a very long work with Rafael Bessi about other possibilities for transition method chalcogenides. So in this work, we consider other morphologies than the 2A, 1T, 1T and 1-2 prime. And we basically investigate this combination of compositions in this morphology, in this crystal lattices. And this work is very interesting because we can obtain a large number of new type 2 heterostructures, which is the most important for the photovoltaic applications. So in this work, we really show that there is a really big number of possible heterostructures for applications in photovoltaic devices. And we also are investigating this paper we will submit in the next week or In this work, we investigate a monocalcogenide material sandwiched between two HBN capping layers. So the HBN is a band gap about 6 electron volts. So there is a small contribution for the properties around the Fermi level. So in this work, we show that if we make a pressure on the system, so if we decrease the distance between the HBN layers, we can tune the band gap. And a band gap transition occurs at the 13.5 gigapascal. And so the pressure can turn the system from a trivial insulator to a topological insulator. I'll show it here. This work are the production of the last year. And there is a very large number of possibilities for application in photovoltaic devices. However, our work is to find the better ways. And we are working on this team. So thank you very much for your attention.
We are now open for questions.
Thanks for the presentation. And we've explored quite much the effects of size and change of the composition of the decalcogenide we are working with to modulate the electronic and other properties of the material. For the future, beyond those variations, would you indicate some that we should explore systematically to see how we can generate possible functional materials based on the TMDs?
For the future, really, in our work saying about density functional theory calculations, it's very important to simulate really the interaction between the two layers. Because in this work, we infer our results from isolated two-dimensional layers. And when we really stack the two layers, form the ether structures, we can have modifications in the band gap. We have a charge transfer, and we can change the properties. So the next step, I think we must to go, is to really simulate the real ether structures with two different materials. So this is the idea indicates.
Thank you. Think in the photovoltaic applications, which are the desired properties to keep in mind to a good performance in this area, and how can be related with the results? For me, it's unclear.
The desirable results. For example, for heterostructures, we must have a type 2 heterostructures. For the band gap, it's important to have a band gap around 1.6 electron volts, because this maximizes the sunlight absorption. And in practice, depends on the configuration of the device. You can, for example, for lateral ether structures, we have to minimize the barrier between the two systems. So it's very difficult to provide a recipe to get better results. But the principal points is the band gap, the low binding energy, exciton energy, and the morphology of the system.
I would just like to complete something for you, is that beyond what Matteo said, it's also necessary to have a small band offset on those materials in the junction. And just to say something about what has been published in the literature, a very recent paper has proposed the heterojunction between the tellurite, molybdenum tellurite, and tellurium. So people is still searching for materials with those desired properties.
Matheus, thank you for the showing the results. Nice. I was curious about the nanoflake deposited onto gold surface, on the gold surface. I once tried to make this type of system, not with nanoflakes, but with monolayers of the some decalcogenides, for example, zinc selenide, zinc telluride. Mm-hmm. And what happens at room temperature is that with only a few in a few hours, the material will migrate inside the gold structure. So I imagine that these simulations don't consider temperature effects, but I would like to know what's your opinion about this process, this migration process, and if you have any kind of experimental data on systems like that, please.
Oh, in this particular system, there is no demigration because the interaction between the sulfur and the gold atoms is well known for other systems. And here we can, and the binding energy, if you for very, if you rotate, you have an increase of 2 electron volts in the binding energy. So I think these flakes are really anchored to the gold substrates. I don't expect that the system migrates or it's very different. For example, for the graphene, there is the adsorption of nanoflakes on graphene. The interaction is much lower, is much weaker interaction, and migration is expected. But here, the system is really anchored to the surface, the gold surface.
Let's think the speaker once again.